God bless you out there, global Christian friends. God bless the American people, government, military, farmers out there. God bless you out there, your walk in life. Whether you're on ground, above the ground, or in the air, God bless you out there across the earthly world, the American people, church, and pastors. We love you. And we are doing this because God wants you to know what's out there across the world, that most of us don't have an idea what's out there. Now, mind you, we said also that these individuals do not believe in Jesus. We have to understand that. And we've given you all kinds of Socratic teachings out there that they get involved in, including digging a hole in the ground and consulting with the dead, the way that they did with Samuel, the witch of Endor, another way of doing these things. God wants you to know. God don't want his people to be ignorant of anything. Remember what the Apostle Paul said, I will not have you ignorant, brethren, concerning spiritual things. Well, God do not have ignorant children out there. Just I got to tell it like it is. God do not have children out there going through either. You're going through is because of your lack of knowledge or lack of understanding or misuse of the power, or you're not hearing deep enough, or you're being misled or mistaught. All right? How many of you out there know what you're hearing today? I can tell you out there that it ain't many of you out there that know what you're hearing today. But Jesus said, make unknown things known. I want to read it again before I move back into it. He said, for nothing is secret that shall not be made manifest, neither anything hid that shall not be known and come abroad. And here it comes. Here it comes, coming down. All right, now. We're back at this angel, or back at this scripture, where the proclamation is made. God will command his angel regarding you to, you know where this came from, the adversary with Jesus, after he fasted 40 days, in all your ways. They will carry you on their hands, lest you strike your foot on a stone. Psalms 91, verse 11 and 12. This indicates that these angels safeguard such an individual from the power of all harmful forces because he is studying the Torah. Now, be careful about what you hear and how you hear. As Jesus said, take heed how you hear. All right? You must take heed how you hear. All right? If we don't, we will think that the thing that we're hearing is right, and we will pursue those. Don't write me, don't call me, don't talk to me about them, okay? I'm only doing what God bid me to do. Reveal them to you. I'm not going to get into them no deeper than what you hear here now. I'm not going to spend the time to do what I've taken years to accomplish, to understand and to know these things, to go back over. I don't do that. All right, there's no need for those kind of things. God brought me through all this stuff. When they wanted to build me a synagogue because of God's knowledge, he gave me, I said no. All right, they did want to build me a synagogue. Rich, wealthy people, I said no. And not only that, but I had the chance also to be given a pastoralship over a Hindu temple and church. God said no. I said no. I don't do what God don't permit me to do, all right? Neither should you. All right, praise the Lord out there. Now, in the middle of this chamber, there is a special, very high place. Now, I can tell you, quite frankly speaking, though they know this, though they say this, though they do this, not one has ever entered into that special high place. Not one. All right? I can tell you that without a doubt. All right? It has four gates open to the four directions, with 10 angels overseeing each gate. 40 of them. A great angel, Hadriel, A-H-A-D-R-I-E-L, a great angel, Hadriel, oversees the angels at each gate. The task of these great angels is to punish the soul which has committed a sin for which the penalty is 39 lashes. Remember the Apostle Paul in 2 Corinthians 11:24, somewhere thereabout. They stand ready with rods of fire, and they emerge from this chamber to punish the soul. Now, since it has sin, it is in a state of excommunication, and it cannot enter the chamber until it has received its punishment as decreed from on high. Now, these angels are ready and prepared to ban and excommunicate the person who do not keep his mouth from speaking evil. This includes those who defile with lips, with vile language, as well as those who swear falsely or unnecessarily. Since such a person is excommunicated by these angels, his prayers are not accepted for 40 days. Each day, a loud announcement is proclaimed in all the heavens before everyone in the world. It declared these words: be careful of this man. Know that he is in a state of excommunication because of the sin that he has committed. At night, when such a soul make its usual pilgrimage to heaven, it finds all the gates closed. Now think about that. We'll come back to this and continue on down the line next time. God bless you, global Christian friends and America.